dark cannabis. Well, this is America of a century ago that was building big and building well and doing just great things. And then last night, I spent about an hour in here by myself, about midnight. And it grieved history to me. I thought long about the centennial. From the first, when I came here, I noticed that the cornerstone of the state of 1893, I knew that we would be doing some sort of a centennial in 1993, since that was coming up shortly, as here it is. Began to think of the people who had a little brick church on this spot, and the front doors faced State Street over here with the pictures that I've seen. I have seen a picture we have in the archives of our congregation of the sanctuary. Very simple sanctuary built in 1860-61. I thought of the people who designed that, and then the people who had a larger vision, I was willing to say, because they were the very same folks, to say 30 years after that building was built, this place is too small. And we can look forward and grow a bigger congregation. To do that, we need to grow a bigger building. And so they began to work at that. Now, fortunately, they had some people who were benefactors and come up with a lot of money. But many, many members of the congregation from a century ago, people who sat where you are sitting now, also worked very hard. The ladies of the church, as they always do, they have a dinner again planned for March 6th of this year. Back then, they were probably doing many, many dinners and all kinds of fundraising projects. And it cost them the staggering sum, $25,000, to be able to put the key in the door and open it and say, "Let us worship." $25,000. Isn't that amazing? My goodness sakes, I'm not sure that you could renovate the interior. You might need a wall picture for that much money anymore. I began to think of the pastors. And I've connected with them because many of their pictures are pictures of many of the pastors are on the wall, and I've identified about 20 more, and I've just gotten into this project. I went over to the United Methodist Archives at Lycoming College and looked through all the old conference journals and just searched through the files that they had there and looked at some of the stuff from the former
years and how that they have been a real landmark in the town and a leader in social ways. I don't know if they observed Prohibition, but certainly the Methodist Church was largely responsible for Prohibition. We have the Methodist miracle. The Methodist miracle is to return wine back into grape juice, because we're responsible, you see, for Prohibition. And James Welch was a Methodist and thought it was unconscionable to have wine for communion, and so he began to market grape juice, and you probably have some of his products in your house today. I thought of other ways that the church has served and ministered. I thought of the pageant. I sat here back there last night and wondered, because I've heard all these stories, and now I've been a part of them for two pageants, and heard how Laura Wright was disgusted with the lousy literature and how Mrs. Vaughn, who's nicknamed by at least two people I know here, was strong medicine. No-nonsense lady, I'm told. And she said to Laura, "Well, if you don't like it, write one yourself." And so she did. And I thought of those kids who were angel boys and young girls who were angels. And I'm going to ask Laura to come forward and begin a special presentation. You see, for a full third of the life of this congregation, the pageant has been the hallmark and the leading edge of lay ministry. And Laura, and Mrs. Duval long ago began.
Our church is like most others as you pass by or enter through, the windows stained, the wooden pews, and Christ's own message too. But like no other, we've been blessed with something they have not. A simple, tiny woman who one day had a thought to direct a Christmas pageant unlike those she'd seen before. So she sat right down and wrote it with her Christian life before. It took much dedication, many hours of thought and prayer, for her to pen this Christmas play to which few can now compare. And though it started small at her desk one early morn, she surely felt God's presence as the search for peace was born. Just this last December marked the years at 33 with 5 full performances for all to come and see. And for all of those who come, or are in it, or behind, the answer for this search for peace is there for all to find. We all know this woman's Lara, whom we honor here today, and to show our appreciation, we knew no better way. So we chose this Sunday morning, January 24, to let her hear our words of praise as we present them by the score. And now, Lara, if you'll please come up, I have a little presentation I'd like to give you.
We can just hold off on that part. Okay. Just for them.
Okay. Sit back down. Sit back down.
Bobby and Betty would come. You're a trustee too. We have a little export back. Mm-hmm. Yeah, one of the presentations of Bob and Betty was up there. This goes back quite a while. In fact, we'll talk about that in a minute, but we have a very lovely presentation. And you have a lot to do with, although you didn't know.
About 15 years ago, Laura pulled into my driveway, and she said, "I have something I want you to look at." It was a mule post, a big piece of wood, beautiful piece of wood. She said, "I'd like you to carve something that would be appropriate for the church." And I said, "What would you like me to carve?" She said, "Oh, you know, like Laura, you'll think of something." So every year, for 15 years, I tried to think of something. And when I was reshuffling my treasures in my garage, I'd move into a different corner each year, and I'd say to myself, "Okay, listen." But I never did. I never thought of it. I'll tell you why I didn't. This little post is over 150 years old. It's out of the parsonage that they tore down here 15 years ago. And I was afraid to cut into it because I was afraid there wouldn't be enough significance. One day, around the 1st of November, Kurt Hort was up in my shop. We were talking about different things, and I said, "I want to show you a piece of wood."
Well, the Bob had mentioned, this came about, I got quite a deal that I worked on, and I've been after him quite a while. It's a shame to see the amount of waste in life. I'm not saying enough material or enough to be hard to come out of that shop.
on that banister?
I don't like the bigger one.
You know, man.
Laura, everything here is from the Lord.
Is that right?
Yeah. There's nothing extra there. That's all from the Lord. And I have a little box of wood if I can make my coat.
I wonder if there's many people in the congregation from the pageant. You didn't know this, and almost found out by accident because I had mailed out little thank yous to everybody, Mark, Gabe, and John's, and inside was a little slip that said, "Remember January 24th, but somehow Mark got out of the way and made a bogus copy and said, "I was close." Anyway, they're good at keeping secrets. But I wonder if some of you from the pageant or the congregation might like to give witness this morning or some words of your own for the occasion today in honoring Laura.
Who came here?
Maybe so, you can cut our vision by the
spirit. I remember years ago when I was still in high school, I was an angel for 4 years. And Mrs. Wright spent so much time with us during practice. And yet, we'd seen the pageant before previously. And you know, without that pageant, it wouldn't be Christmas. I went 1 year without seeing the pageant. It was around Christmas time. It just wasn't the same. Don't ever do away with it.
We have two new boxes, and we want to use one too. Would you like to share a word?
Not really.
If I might take a minute, Laura and I go way back. In fact, go back to when I was about 9 years old. I lived in the east end part of Fairfield, and she was my neighbor. And I remember going to Lyric Theater and watching some of the performances that Laura took part in on the stage. So if you go back to basic fundamentals of lyrics, might go back quite a way. Laura started real young in life. Well, it bloomed into what we see here as a pageant, and she's no newcomer to the Lyric Theater, whatever it might offer.
We built the first part of the platform up there for the pageant, and we helped for quite a while. And down, Kurt had to stand there, pack the whole pageant, holding the curtains up.
Here, you're drafted. Thank you. Our choir can sing. Both of your choir can sing once again.
Good.
Thank you.
you've been a part of today is taking commitment, the C word. Church, Carol Michaels, if she would offer the blessing.
Bow our heads. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, for this special honor of our loved one, Laura, for her work in the ministry, for the sharing of the search for peace for all to see. We thank you for all these ladies that who have done the work in the kitchen. We ask your blessing upon this food. And us to thy service. In Jesus' name, amen.
You should have signed up with everything you said. There are people who have grandchildren and who have had grandchildren.
box, right here, the silver. One more.
My kids think I'm eating.
Great.